So let's say you work for a global shipping company and your manager asks you to figure out how to improve operations. You create a bunch of charts and tables to crunch the numbers, but they're not fully explaining where the problem is. And that's the key, where? As a shipping company, what you're dealing with is location-based data. There are a lot of factors that can impact your bottom line when an entire country or region, or even the whole world, is your arena. Those things aren't always clear when you're looking at data points in the abstract. What you need is context, a way to see how close or far apart stuff is, how it clusters together, and how it moves from one place to another. That's why SAP Analytics Cloud enables you to visualize your location-based data in GeoMaps. Let's have a look at your shipping data to illustrate how it works. You start by making sure your data includes location dimensions that can be displayed in maps. Here in the model, a location dimension has already been created for the depots, but the stores still need to be done. You could just geo-enrich your stores using the names or ISO codes for the countries or regions they belong to. You have a column with all the country names in it here. But your data also includes precise latitude and longitude coordinates, so you create a location dimension that shows each store as a unique data point instead. Easy, right? Next, you add a GeoMap to your story to show your store locations. You could display the stores as a bubble layer or a heat map, but you want to be able to show stores by country, so you choose a choropleth layer, which lets you drill up and down in the geo hierarchy. You also change the color of the country shapes to reflect the average shipping time. Well, that tells you where some of the problems are. For example, Tanzania seems to wait a while for its shipments. But if you want to really impact the bottom line, you need to figure out where you should be focusing your efforts. So you change the style of the layer to show the countries as bubbles, playing a bit with the colors to highlight where stores are waiting longer than 15 days to get their deliveries, and then adjust the bubble size to reflect gross margin. Wow, that's a big outlier. You should definitely be trying to keep your German stores happy. Because of the outlier, parts of the map are hard to see. So you make a quick adjustment to how the bubble looks when it's that big, and then drill down into the outlier to take a closer look. That's kind of busy, so you make a few more changes to get a better look at the individual stores. So what next? Well, the sales managers for these store locations may have some insights, so you add their names to the tooltip for the bubbles. A few quick calls, and you have some suggestions to follow up on. One idea is that maybe some of the stores with longer wait times are farther away from ports where the deliveries can come in, so you add another layer to show the port locations. It's hard to eyeball the distances, so you add a distance filter to identify stores that are more than 500 kilometers away from a port. That's probably not it. There are stores that are getting their deliveries in good time that aren't close to a port. So you zoom in a bit closer using a polygon filter and check out some of the reasons for the delay in shipment. The segments of the pie chart are described here in the legend, but you're still not seeing an obvious difference between the store locations with speedy delivery times and those that take longer. What now? Well, maybe you're still not looking at the data the right way. This time, you trace the path of the deliveries all the way from depot to store using a flow layer. Okay, now you're getting somewhere. That does not look right. Why are deliveries being sent from the US depot to Europe? You do a quick check of the order volume coming out of the depots to see if you're missing something. But it seems like the US depot could be downgraded to serving only the Americas, while the depot in Germany takes over the deliveries everywhere else. A quick click on the individual depots lets you see more details in other widgets on the page through linked analysis. And there you have it, a solution all mapped out for you. That was just a selection of the features available when you use a GeoMap in SAP Analytics Cloud. Give it a try for yourself and see where it can take you.